There are fears that a key transport route could be shut down. The so-called Northern Distribution Network connects Afghanistan overland with ports in the Black Sea and also with Baltic ports via Central Asia, the Caucasus and Russia. There are fears that NATO's deteriorating relations with Russia over Ukraine could lead Moscow to shut down the route to the Baltic. Andrew Foxall is an analyst with the Henry Jackson Society in London.
In early April, NATO halted all collaboration with Russia, and the suggestions over the last few days that NATO's offices in Moscow will be closed down. So in that sense, I think it's increasingly likely that Putin will play this card, the ace in the pack effectively that he has with regards to NATO's withdrawal from Afghanistan.
The cost of the US withdrawal alone is estimated at $6 to $7 billion. NATO as a whole has already shipped 86,000 vehicles and containers. Viable alternative routes have allowed the operation to move ahead of schedule, says retired Brigadier Ben Barry of the International Institute for Strategic Studies.
The other route is the land route over the passes from Pakistan down to Karachi and thence by sea. And in addition, many NATO countries have been flying a lot of their heavy equipment out of Afghanistan, usually to a port in the region.
Barry says there are good reasons why Russia would not want to disrupt the route out of Afghanistan.
The countries that are doing this are paying good, solid Western cash for this.
Yet for Russian President Vladimir Putin, economics often comes second to strategy, according to Andrew Foxall.
Russia receives about $1 billion a year from NATO, for NATO using Russian territory for transit purposes. But as we've seen in Ukraine and Crimea, I don't necessarily think that the economic costs are high on Putin's agenda when he's making these geopolitical calculations.
Moscow supported the West after the terrorist attacks of 9/11, and the fear that Afghanistan could once again become an exporter of terrorism still unites Russia and the West, says Brigadier Ben Barry.
In the inner councils of the Russian government, for example, in its National Security Council, there will be voices arguing for making sure that security transition in Afghanistan happens as well as it could do, because the last thing Russia needs is more instability on another of its borders.
Tongan troops performed a traditional war dance this week to mark the end of their mission, ahead of their long flight home back to the South Pacific. Getting the equipment out is a far more challenging task. Henry Ridgewell for VOA News, London.